Alright, so here's a cool little orange fuzz, kind of one-off thing, tweaked a bunch of stuff around. This is your overall volume. This is like pre-volume, like your guitar's volume, but without the treble loss. You can see it's very sensitive when I start playing it. This biases the output transistor, so you can get it from like normal fuzz to a little saggy to super zippery, like some sort of Satisfaction Buzz-ass Range Master type territory, but more aggressive. And then this is your overall output bass content, so here's some clean. Is your output of the bass. So get some more normal fuzz, getting the bias kind of towards the bottom. It can affect the headroom. So this can get it really woofy. So here it is with it down. Probably gonna adjust that so the floor goes even more bass swept, so it'll be more dramatic. Here's on the neck, so even more bass. Thank you. crispy. It's like. So it's really harmonically rich. It's really awesome. Under biasing it by turning this bias all the way down, it gets a nice little thick sag. High-end harmonics, you turn it up just a hair and you get it all back. You get more as you turn it up. Zippery when you crank this up, obviously. So nice and splattery when you play chords, but on the single notes, it's that total buzz stuff. Features, you know, you turn some knobs and get kind of a unique voice for yourself. I wanted it to have the ability to get that woof though. So it handled the lows well, you know. I'm a bassist, so I like lows. There's on some neckage. Thank you. bridge, you just get these crazy screeching highs. It's awesome. Caps instead of poly caps in it, so I mixed it up a little bit just to get the more of that crunchy vintage vibe. I think that's where some of the uniqueness is. It's got a mix of transistors too, so just kind of making it really very uniquely voiced Fuzz. Awesome. Party on.